I guess the film starts really with Gemma's character breaking up with the guy that I play, really, and he kind of messed with her life. You know, he was cheating on her. They had something good, and you know, he messed it up. And then she goes on this kind of journey of self-discovery, and then my character comes back into her life and tries to turn things upside down again by saying, you know, I love you, and I messed up, and please forgive me. But you know, things have changed. So yeah.
You're working with a beautiful actress in Gemma Arterton. Can you talk about that experience and what you think she specifically brings to that central character?
I think she's such a natural actress. She's a natural person. She's very warm, and you know, there's a sensitivity there as well. You know, she brings a lot of natural detail. Very, very elegant, and she brought a lot of beautiful warmth, I would say. You know. Yeah.
Have you got a specific memory or a specific example of that kind of warmth, that kind of elegance you're talking about?
I guess just, you know, just the way she is. She's just very natural. You know, she's natural in life, but then she brings that to camera as well. Which is, you know, it's a hard thing to do that. France, because it's, you know, Normandy, that part of the world is very, you know, provincial. And then having kind of the British characters come into that world, it's quite interesting, because the relationship between England and France and all that's in, you know, that's in the film. I've got a film being released later this year called Legend, about the craze. I'm in that, and there's a film next year called Disappointments Room, and I've just finished something called Myth of Hopelessness, which is a great little indie film, quite a dark black tale, black comedy about a guy who's a tetraplegic and his carer. So quite a twisted black film, but really beautifully done. So yeah.